Hi, I'm Willa Sipple.
And I'm Seraphina Foreman. Welcome to Tell It Like It Is.
Two weeks ago, the country witnessed an extremist act of anti-Semitism at the shooting of the Tree of Life Synagogue in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
11 congregants were murdered during a service as a white man opened fire while yelling anti-Semitic hate speech. Within the past couple of weeks, the nation has witnessed several other hate-driven terrorist attacks, such as the shooting at the yoga studio in Florida, the murder of two black people in Kentucky, and the shooting at the California bar this past Wednesday.
We sat down with Rabbi Justin David at Congregation B'nai Israel to discuss how the Jewish community in Northampton is coming together to recover from the shooting.
Oh, my initial reaction was one of just being completely stunned. I heard about it in the middle of services on Saturday morning at about 11 o'clock, and a member of our congregation who's from Pittsburgh came in, and he looked totally crestfallen. I mean, like, you know, like how you might see someone, you know, once or twice in their lives. And he told me, and I was completely shocked because something like this hasn't occurred in a synagogue in over 50 years. So the general Northampton community has been incredibly generous in their outpouring of love and support. We had about, 600-700 people here a week ago Monday night, many of whom weren't even from the Jewish community, coming out to show their solidarity. The people I'm really concerned about, though, are African-American churches and Latino community centers that are so visible and where this targeting doesn't go away so easily. The synagogue is a very safe place. It's a very open place. Everyone is welcome at any time. We don't want these events to change that, and we really believe in the power of our community.
We attended a rally at Congregation B'nai Israel and spoke with many people from different backgrounds coming together to fight white supremacy and violence.
What we're seeing in the last few years is an uptick in all kind of violent crimes against religious minorities, people of color, women. I think this election day showed us that we are standing in solidarity, not just in practice and words, but in policy and the ways that we move.
I'm seeing so much unification and so much solidarity. And I don't even think it's just solidarity. Like, people actually are grieving with the Jewish community, even if they're not Jewish.
Tenemos que estar unidos más que nunca por la razón, por esa razón de que está pasando en estos tiempos de mucho racismo, como tú decías, mucha discriminación, mucho odio racial. Entonces tenemos que unirnos. Esa es la razón por qué tenemos que unirnos. Y si nos unimos, es como vamos a tener más fuerza, más poder, más podremos lograr, creo, muchas cosas.
An incident like this reminds me, as a Christian pastor, of a particular responsibility that Christians, I believe, have of owning some of the history of white supremacy and anti-Semitism and finding new and more powerful ways of standing in solidarity with Jewish brothers and sisters, with Muslim brothers and sisters, and against hatred.
Thanks for watching, and we hope we can all remember the people who have passed on and move forward together.
Thanks for watching. This was Tell It Like It Is.
We attended at